Hello, my beautiful creative friends. I am just so happy to be here today, and I wanted to create something because I recently got their Joggles rice papers, and I know you guys have been seeing them because I put them on a little short right before this, so you could actually see them. So I didn't have to take a long time during this video to actually show them each. You can go back and see them on my channel. I'm going to leafing through all of them, but today I'm going to be working with them because I find that they're a little bit difficult to work with. These are the ones that I'm going to be working with this set. There's a few sets and I find them difficult because they're just so beautiful and I never want to like use them. I don't want to rip them. I don't know how to just glue this whole thing in my journal, but what's the point in that? It's no fun if you're just gluing and not doing anything with it. So I really wanted to kind of take it to the next level, and I'm going to be working in my Dina Wakley art journal. This is one of them. And I am just going to work on the second one that is here. So I have, this is the blue cover, but I'm working specifically in these like thick cotton papers, okay? I'm on a double spread, and I already pre-gessoed these pages with clear gesso. What the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add paint. And I use two colors. This is the also Dina Wakley acrylic paint. I've been really heavily into acrylic paint, not only Dina's, but also I've been buying like a bunch of paint from like different companies because I've been just really trying to get a bunch of, you know, paints that I want, the colors that I want. So I'm using two colors, the eggplant and the olive. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply them to the background. So what I was trying to do is basically match the colors from these. And I was going to add orange as well. But when I started combining these two colors together, which are super similar to the ones in the background, they started turning orange on their own, and you're going to see what happens this way. Okay. All right. So I'm going to start. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start adding it to the background, and I'm not like being very specific about where I'm adding it. I'm kind of spreading it all around. It doesn't really matter where you add it. What I like about the acrylic paint is that because it's heavy body, it gives you really good coverage. So it's really nice to add in the background, because I'm going to show you a really cool technique on how I created those branches that you saw in the journal. Okay. And it has a really cool name that I actually wrote down because I want to make sure that you guys know how to spell it, because it's not an easy thing to spell. Oh, I just grabbed the wrong one. Oops, this is fuchsia. I should move around and I could tell that it wasn't even the same color, but that's okay. It's very similar, the fuchsia and the blackberry. I did not mean to do that. I meant to put the eggplant and instead I put fuchsia. Okay, well, this one will be. This is what happens during lives. I end up making mistakes because I don't pay attention. I'm nervous and I don't pay attention. Okay, let me add the green. Let me put some green. This is the olive green. I'm going to need a bunch of it. And when you'll see now, when I start mixing the two colors, the orange becomes the same orange as this cheddar color. So I would just thought it was cool, and it actually matched perfectly because I was going to originally add the orange. If you do want it, you know how you should probably wash your paintbrush, but I don't mind having a mixture of all the colors together. You're not really going to see most of it. I'm just kind of painting it. You can use a sponge dauber and do this as well. But yeah. So yeah, this is a really large journal. It's an 8x10. So you do need a lot of paint to cover it. Not a lot, but you know what I mean? Like you need more than just, like, I usually work on the smaller journals, the Diane Reevely one. I think they're like 5x8, but this one is 8x10 and it tends to, you know, you need a lot of paint to cover it. But this is why acrylic paint is great for that. So just going to cover it. who knew? I mean, probably somebody knew that green and eggplant fuchsia make brown, and not brown, orange. I don't know why. I thought orange was made from yellow. But somehow I have it made from this. I'm going to add a little bit more green. So, hey, that's probably, you're right. That's probably how Dina came with the cheddar color, because she just kind of mixed the two. I don't know. Who knows? Okay, I'm going to just clean my brush a little, because I do want a little bit of green here. Although, as I said, most of it will be kind of covered. But you'll see why this needs to be in the background in a few minutes. It's a really cool technique that, of course, I came up by accident because I love experimenting. I really feel like one of the things that I love doing, I never realized how much I love doing this. Forget about experimenting, but I love kind of breaking the boundaries of creativity, to just break everything and make it possible, make it like, you know, like attainable and really creative, and find things that, you know, we've never done before. So, yeah. Okay, so I am almost done. And you could use a little bit of water if you want to kind of blend it more. You could, if you use a little bit of water, like you could blend it a little bit more. But I don't feel, I want it really dark, okay? And the paint takes on beautifully on top of the gesso. There we go. I covered the whole background. And it's, oh my God, it's absolutely okay, so I'm going to dry this. I'm going to dry that. The thing about acrylic paint is that it dries nice and quick. Okay. Yay. So now I have these ones, and I have to kind of decide where I want to place some of these, okay? I think I want to use kind of this one. And there's two options you can do. You could rip or you could cut. And, oh, I have one more. So I didn't have doubles of everything, okay? But I have this feather that is part of the other design that I used as well, and I really like it to be here. So what I'm going to do is I'm kind of going to rip underneath. The reason why I rip is you can tell that there is fibers. There is very nice fibers on the rice paper. So when you rip it, those fibers kind of become really, I don't know, I want to say hairy, but they become really beautiful. They give so much texture. Yeah, they become kind of like a feather, which is perfect for what I want to do, okay? But if you don't like ripping or you're scared of ripping, don't be afraid, which I can't tell you what to do, or cut around it. So I'm going to leave this one here. I really like this design over here. I want to maybe at the top here because I have the corner. And then I have this extra feather I'm going to save for another day because I don't know what I want to do with it. And I'm going to cut just this edge here. It's just a label. And all the supplies are linked below in the description area. So you can just go ahead and if you want to purchase any of these, they're from Joggles. My stencils and stamps are also from Joggles. I don't know if you've ever seen them. So yeah. I'm not going to get a little bug. I'm going to put another type of bug there. So I'm just cutting kind of around it. There we go. So this can go in the corner over here. I'm not sure if, oh, there's a little bug over there. I didn't even notice it. No, you know what? I'm going to cut a little bit more out of this. I know that a lot of people love bugs and I don't mind them, but I don't think they fit this design right now. Now I want, I really like this little bit here. So I'm going to use it. So the nice thing about rice papers is that you can combine different designs together. Joggles is not the only company that sells them. Stamperia and also Ciao Bella. Even Prima, I think, has them. Like, there's just a lot of companies that sell them. I listed, like, the ones that I thought were the best. So, oh, yeah, this is nice. Okay. And I really would like, I would love, do I need anything else? Or is it getting too full? Maybe. Oh, you know what? There is also, like, some that are, like, this. So I wonder if I could just add like something like this one. I think that would be perfect for that. And again, I'm going to rip it. So, okay, and I'm actually cutting this one around just because. Okay. So now I can go around and do this. And I can always go back and add more if I really want to. Okay, I'm almost done ripping. Okay, there we go. And now I am. Okay, so as with any type of like collage or anything like that, you can do it. You can glue things with like gel medium, which is my favorite thing to do. And this is my favorite gel medium. It's not gel medium. This is my favorite matte medium. It's a matte liquid gel medium, which is perfect for, I love using it the most, if that makes sense. And I like applying it with a paintbrush. So I literally just go like this and I just put it, oops, I just put it in the corner. And oopsie doopsie. So I just put this in the corner, try to get as much, or you can put it in the back of the paper as well, but I put it in the corner. And the most important thing when you're collaging is to make sure that you seal everything really well. These papers are really thin and they can get damaged, especially if you're adding more wet mediums, which I'll probably do. So I need to make sure that they're not getting damaged. So you're just sealing them helps. Okay, and oh my gosh, the corners are always also tricky because you need to kind of get to them. Again, I'm sealing, and the nice thing about this, it dries clear and it dries matte, so you don't even see it. Okay, so as I'm working with it, a lot of like, it just looks weird, right? Like it looks like, oh my gosh, how is that going to turn into the same thing that she just showed us? There's no way. It has to, like, you know, there's, how do we work with these to make them fit our designs? This is where it's a little bit more difficult. And I find that there is many different ways of doing it besides collaging. And a lot of the times that I've worked before, I've used like things like white to kind of hide the edges because I could really easily use white to hide here. But I wanted to show you how you can actually use color as well to do something similar. It doesn't have to always be white, you know? And one of the things that, I guess I'm getting to the bottom of the of my box. one of the things, this type of classes that you see here, the way I'm teaching it today, this is how I teach my members and patrons on Patreon and on my membership. A lot of you are my members. A lot of the people that are that are here are members of my channel and come and get two classes a month. And basically what I am doing with the members this month is that the second, depending on the tier that you work on, you're going to get, depending on what tier it is, you get other videos. So the $10 members already, I'm cutting one more of these. So the $10 members already got this month, where I use like a masking kind of technique. But this month, because I am doing this one with the rice papers, I'm going to be using, I wanted to be doing a more in-depth on the rice papers using these ones. Aren't they stunning? So my next class, which is this Saturday, for patrons of my higher level, it's going to be probably like a 2-hour class, just going in depth into how to use these. And this is the class I want to show you. I was debating whether or not to show it to you. But I figured that I will show you the class just in case you want to join and do this, because it's like really, so it's a very similar, very similar colors, but what we're going to get into, we're going to get a little bit more into masking and stamping and collaging and just spending, like adding a lot of finishing touches to things. So it's going to be more in depth, and you can definitely do it in any color you like, depending on what things you have. And I'm going to be posting that, but if you do want to join my Patreon, you can definitely do that. The link is in the my video's description. And yeah, I would love to have you and join us, because it's live classes like this where you get to work one-on-one. So you get to work with me like this, and you get to ask questions and be able to kind of interact. Okay, I do want this one here. So yeah, so this one is not going to be exactly the same, not only because I didn't have the same papers. I had like papers from the same design, from the same collection, but not from the same papers. So I wanted to make sure that I have it, that it looks similar, but it won't be exactly the same. Okay. And a little bit more, I feel like something is missing here at the bottom. So I am going to kind of go over and use a little bit more. So this is the last bit. So sometimes we just need to build. We don't know how much we're going to need, and that's okay. You're kind of like going to gauge it depending on the size of your journal and how much you need to cover. You still want to leave some white space, even though this is not technically white in the color white, it's still considered white space. And it's important to kind of leave so not everything gets covered by images and other things, okay? So I think I don't know if I want so much of this here. And don't be afraid to use these. I mean, to tell you the truth, these rice papers are not expensive. And like, I feel like a lot of people are afraid to use them because they don't want to ruin them, right? Who would want to ruin this? You don't want to ruin a design or anything like that. But having them like used and just going for it makes a difference. So it's important to do that, you know? Okay. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to like kind of glue this here. Okay, there we go. I think I am done. I'm just going to dry this. Okay, this I'm good now, and I'm going to dry this. Okay, so So like I said before, I've used white to do a lot of like the masking on, to kind of blend the edges. But in this case, instead of using white, I decided that I wanted to use gold. And I felt like gold, I mean, you guys know how much I love gold. Yes, I know, I'm a gold girl. A lot of people are like, some people are definitely silver people, but I am definitely a gold person. I think everything looks gold. So I just decided to do that. And the heavy body is important because I want to be able to cover the edges. So what I do is I basically start pouncing around the edges, okay? And then the rest, I just kind of paint, okay? But first, I'm going to pounce around the edges, and I'll tell you why in a second, because this is the key of this technique that I'm going to show you. If you've done acrylic painting before on its own, not like crafting, then you might know the name of this technique, not the masking. I mean, I will tell you the name of the technique in a second. But you see how it really covers everything beautifully? It makes it, it kind of blends the edges to the background. And you can go in as much as you want if you kind of want to create, that effect, okay? Now I need to add more paint to show you this technique. So 1 second. Oh, I think there's some green on this. All right, I'm gonna do just this side first. Okay, so I'm just pouncing on the sides here. And you want this acrylic paint, this gold acrylic paint, to be thick enough because, and this is, hold on, I need an, we're gonna be etching into it, but it's not called etching. It is called sgraffito, and I had to put it in a paper to show you how it works, how it's spelled. It is spelled like this, sgraffito. It's an Italian word for etching, and what it is it's what I did to create these like really cool branches, okay? And the key to this technique, I mean, you could do it with any color, like, you know, we've done it with like the black, you know, with things underneath. But the key to do this with acrylic paint is that you need the darker color to be underneath, or if you're doing black, then a lighter color. So if that makes sense. So this is how I did the branches on this journal, okay? So this is exactly it. So the paint still needs to be a little wet, okay? And that's how you get the branches. And if you, let's say the paint gets dry, just go ahead and add more paint, okay? So if I have reached a point where the paint is drying too fast, because sometimes acrylic paint does dry. Oh, and I forgot that I'm using Amsterdam gold paint. I think it's called deep gold. That's what it's called, okay? So in the center, I'm adding some thicker areas and a little bit of the thinner areas. So I am definitely covering most of it, and you don't have to. You could like go more like of a dry brush effect if you want to, but it's like, oh, oops, wrong side. But I just, the thicker it is, well, actually not the thicker it is, it's not true, because you can scratch off with the thinner ones. So for example, if I made a mistake, oopsie. Sorry, I'm trying to get a paper whip. I can add more gold. So for example, here, there might be too little gold. So I've been, as I said, I've been on a little bit of an acrylic binge. So I've been like, I think I have a different color. See, there's no dark color underneath here. So I could go back if I really want to fix this, okay? I could go back with like one of the darker colors. Hold on, let me get a paintbrush. So let's to really fix this. Let's see if it works. I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna work on another area in the meantime. So the places where, see like where it scratches more is where you have like the darker area. I think there was green here and the green doesn't show as well under the gold. But it really makes it look so cool. I don't know. I just feel like it just adds so much to it. And okay, I'm going to So a lot of the rice paper that is out there is blank, and like people use it for gel printing and other things, which I actually just recently bought some for gel printing because I wanted to try it out, but I didn't do it with these other designs. I kind of, I left it, I am using them more for collaging and other things like that. Okay. And the reason why this helps with the pouncing, you can also use a sponge if you really want to, is because it kind of blends the edges a lot. So you get like these like really nice blended edges. Okay, let me put this down. Go back with the paintbrush. I mean, look, I'm using like the back of my paintbrush. That's basically, actually it's cool now. So there's so many really cool design to your work, and it just makes it really shine. Oh, I really like that. Okay, so I'm going to dry. I really like these leaves. Okay, I'm gonna put this aside, and I need to dry this because I want to show you what I'm going to do next. And if you see something while it's drying that needs fixing, you can always do that. You can also, like, if you really want to, you can also, like, do a little bit of a really light wash with the gold, okay? So to add, like, even a little bit of water. And you could add, to make it all match, you could add a little bit of a gold wash to some of this, okay? So it just matches the background a little bit better. I didn't do this with the first one, but I just thought of it now. I just think like just sometimes just matching like some of the white areas kind of stand out a lot. So this helps with that. And the nice thing is that you also have like the darkness from the behind. So you can, once it starts drying, you can really see. It still looks really weird. I find like sometimes it looks weird until we blend everything and we work with it fully. So until you work with this, you're like kind of like, it kind of looks disappointing, if that makes sense. But it's not once you finish working with it. And I like that some of that redness or the pink is showing underneath because it really looks like different. You know, the trees kind of look different depending on where they are. Okay, so now this is something cool that I did is that I took the eggplant and the blackberry color, mix them together because I really wanted to be a little bit more purplish. Okay, so I took them to the two of them together, made a little like concoction with it. Oops. All right. And I need a small paintbrush, something like this, that is a flat, small paintbrush. And I'll show you what I'm going to do. So what you want to do is we're going to make these like little, like they look like lotus flowers, like little ones. Okay. And not everything seems dry. And what I did is I basically, I wish I could show you a side view of that. Does that make sense? Okay, hold on. I think I need a little bit more of the blackberry because it's too purplish. Okay. So the way, let me just show you how this is done. Okay. Let's see if I can show it on an angle. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, kind of like just making them almost as like an asterisk. I don't know. I can't like think. Can you guys, is it possible? Can you see it on the thing? Like, it's hard for me to tell if people can see it because I don't know if my hand is covering. I'm trying to look to see if my hand is covering it. And this is how I made those little flowers. And you don't want to make too many because then it's like, then it makes it too many. Okay. This looks like it's really wet. I want to see. Okay. Do I need any more? Sometimes I have to look even in my video to see if I need any more. Actually, in the original one, I put so many and then I ended up removing. So you can actually remove it, but I like it. Yeah. Okay, I think I'm good. I don't want to add too many. Okay. But I still feel it's like too all over the place. So what I did is I actually added, you can't see the color that I mixed here. Okay. I added a little bit of blue to this, just a tiny little bit of the blue. Lapis, I think, tiny little bit. I'm saying tiny little bit and I put a ton. Okay. Okay, I'm going to mix it. Okay. All right. So one sec, I am going to, I need a bigger paintbrush. So hold on. I'm going to get one of the bigger ones because what I want to do is I want to create, and let's see, make sure. Yeah. Create like this, like border around. And the reason why I want this is because it really frames everything. So I'm using my paintbrush and basically applying it going up, like light brush going up to really frame it all in. You think that in, you know, you would think, oh, well, it's just a brush, like it's just a paintbrush. How is that like, you know, why is it making such a difference? But it really is a concept of drawing the eye in into our focal points. And our focal point right now is, I mean, there isn't really a main focal point. It's just the flowers. And I'm going to be definitely put a butterfly there. But what it helps is to kind of draw the eye in into the design. And it really does. It's artists use this in many different ways to create exactly that, to create that focal point. And to draw in the eye to the focal point. Sorry, when I sometimes can't talk. And this is why I do videos beforehand because and edit them, because I can sometimes talk and create at the same time. It's not easy. I would also wonder how teachers do it sometimes, how they are able to teach and pay attention to everything else. I don't know if there's any teachers out there, but I find it like sometimes hard. Sometimes I am good with it, and sometimes I'm just like, okay, how do I do this? So again, it's really easy to just add this, and you want the drier the brush, the better it's going to look. It's going to have those strokes that look really, really cool. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to finish the all around. I feel like I need a little bit more of this. It's kind of becoming very bluish. And although I like it, I feel like I want a little bit more of this like eggplant color because it's just looking very bluish. Okay, the eggplant color adds a little bit more. Also, like What it does is that it also helps with the edges, because the edges are always so like straight and stark, right? And like this kind of blend in things. And you guys are so sweet. Thank you. You guys are amazing too. Okay, so that makes sense. And I could even go, well, I haven't finished this area, but, and I think this flower is kind of get covered a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna continue. Yeah, Tara, this is classes like on with my members. Like, I mean, some of these ladies know because they've been members with me for over a year. So it is like this. It's exactly like this. Very relaxed. Tara's saying that how relaxed it is here. I'm like, yeah. Okay, so I'm going to mix a little bit of gold in this too, just to kind of like add to, you know, you kind of don't want it all to look the same, so that gold can help. Yeah, the gold is like beyond beautiful. I also got not only the gold, I got this one. I want to try it. I haven't tried it yet. It's tin. It's a pewter. That's what it is. I think it's cool. But this gold is really stunning. Yeah. Okay. Oops, I get paint everywhere. Gold for other stuff too, so that's okay. That's why I put a lot more. And I love how the paint, like, I mean, using good acrylic paint, not that you have to use a good acrylic paint. I've used acrylic paint from the dollar store, but using good acrylic paint makes a huge difference. Oh, Terry, use my link. I don't know if I link to Amazon. That's true. I don't know. Press any other Amazon link and then buy it. Okay. Let me just see. Yeah. Okay. Let's just see. Okay, so just continuing to work with the design really makes a difference. Why am I so crooked? Oh, gosh. Okay. Okay. So that's good. What I want to do is with my, where is that paintbrush? Oh gosh, I'm losing my paintbrushes here. With the gold brush, with the thin paintbrush, okay. Actually, I brought another one because I knew this would happen, that I would get too dirty. So I got another paintbrush, and you can even add like little gold flowers, okay? So you can accent the flowers, or you can even accent like the different like branches or the feathers, whatever you want, okay? Like just add like little flowers, little things, you know? I don't know. Just like there's so much to do, like so much to work with. Oh, I can't believe I've been going on for an hour already. But I'm almost done anyway, so that's okay. Ooh. Yeah. And if you see any places where, like, you know, you made a mistake or, like, too much white. Here, there's too much white. I just realized I want the feather to kind of stand out. And there's too much white in between. So you can just, like, do that. Okay, there we go. So, oh, you see that makes. That really like that. And what I can do is the brush and just kind of start the branches from here. Yeah. Does that make a difference? No, I don't think it makes any difference. I do want the branches to go a little bit lower. So I'm going to add more. So this is what I meant before. You can add more paint and then you can just scratch away the branches further down. Okay. So, yeah. And let me see, while looking, I feel like I'm missing some little flowers. Okay, so I'm gonna go back with my color. And I think here it's like missing some flowers. I have really forgotten how much I like going live streaming. Well, when I know what I'm doing and when nothing goes wrong, because the last two times, like my sound was off, I didn't, something didn't work. It drove me nuts. Okay. Okay, so. All right. And well, I really like how that turned out. It's not perfect, but I really love it. I'm going to add a butterfly, which not a butterfly. These are moths, right? I'm saying they're butterflies, but they're actually moths. And I already cut it out. I think, where am I going to put her? Her, him, her. Oh, yeah, that's a good place for her. So let me just dry this area. Hint, hint. Okay, I'm just going to, oops. So I'm just going to put her over here. Yeah, I think that's where she goes perfectly. You see, now she's the focal point. She, and I'm calling her she because she's a moth butterfly in Spanish and other languages. You know, butterflies are females. So I like calling her she. And hold on, just gonna get a brush. Okay. Well, good night, Chrissy. Okay, and I'm going to glue this first, this one. This butterfly, oh, I love her. Okay. And of course, I'm going to go back with my gold because I need to be able to kind of blend the butterfly in the edges in as well. Okay. You want to be able to blend those as well. Just a little bit. And you can even add the wash as well onto it. And you can even go with this and create like the... if you really want to, although I don't know if I like them, but okay, that's good. I'm just adding a little bit more depth into the flowers. I feel they're kind of flat a bit. And then, ooh, I like that. Okay, so. Okay. And then the last thing I did is I just added like some, you know, a sentiment. I actually took it from the Tim Holtz and I pre-chose this because it takes forever to like get these little letters out. And it says, find courage in imperfection, because that's something that I struggle a lot with. Like I want things to look like, you know, the best, but doesn't always happen. And I felt like this is something that is important, not only for me, but for basically most people that are creating, that it's okay to be imperfect, especially in an art journal. You're not selling this. You're not making this for somebody else. You're just making this for yourself. So if you're already making it for yourself, then why stress about how it looks, you know? If you're giving something as a gift, even that handmade stuff should, you know, people should not like ever say anything about it. Although I'm sure there's people that do, but truthfully, I just find that it's really important to find, you know, that courage to be okay with imperfection. Okay, I'm just gluing these only because the stickiness goes away very quickly and I don't want them to fall. Oopsie. And I'm going to just seal them, and I'm actually going to also add some splatters because who doesn't love splatters? Okay, I just want to make sure that these are glued properly. Maybe I added too much, but it will dry clear. The nice thing about the matte medium, it dries clear and everything goes back to normal. Okay, so I'm going to add, I don't actually know, do I need splatters? Do I not need splatters? Maybe I'll add a little bit of water here and just make this really watery. And then I can, really watery, but it's dripping. Okay. And just, because what splatters do, although I don't like this brush for splatters, what splatters do is they kind of blend things together, makes it all look good. So why not? Splatter time. So just a few splatters. And then we're good. I mean, I can always want to fix more and do more, right? But I just feel like this can be done forever. And the reason why I'm adding a few like last strokes here, not only because I have the paint, is because I feel like the middle is a little bit more empty than the other ones. So adding a little bit like of strokes going in really makes a difference. Okay. It's like, it's kind of adds movement. What you want is you want to have that movement, okay? It's really helpful to have movement in your page. Yeah, I really like that a lot. So this is it. I think it turned out pretty close. Let me make sure I didn't forget anything. No, I didn't. So this is the original one. Okay, I didn't add splatters in that one. Okay. Just you can see that some of the elements are different, and I put the butterflies in different places. And this is the new one, and it's just totally different, but still original, still like, you know, still me in this sense. And I'm just so grateful for you guys to be here with me today. And if you want to watch more of my mixed media techniques, especially using collage papers or rice papers or anything that you can like alter, and here's a link for you to watch all the other videos that I have for mixed media.